middle path, moderation. That's what Islam is, moderation. And I was telling him that I've told this to a few brothers before, and I've given a khutbah here on last Eid. I was here. I spoke about, if you remember, some of the brothers that were here, we spoke about the Sahabi of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who's known nowadays as a funny Sahabi. Not many brothers know his name, and if you study Isaba fi Tamyiz al-Sahaba by Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani rahmatullahi ta'ala alayh, you will see some of his stories mentioned in there. His name was Nu'ayman ibn Amr radiyallahu ta'ala an. Nu'ayman ibn Amr, who was known as one of the Sahaba. You know, we look at the Sahaba ikram and we notice people like Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq, Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab, Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan, Sayyidina Ali karamallahu wajhahu al-kareem. May Allah be pleased with all of them. And we look at these people and we think we can be inspired by these people. We can be inspired by the likes, our youth can be inspired by the likes of Mus'ab ibn Umair radiallahu ta'ala an. We can be inspired by them. When we talk about the love for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we think we can be inspired by the story of Sayyidina Uwais al-Qarni radiallahu ta'ala an. We think like that. When I used to read, as a student in Jamia al-Kalam, when I used to read stories of the Sahaba ikram in English, and I used to read these stories in various stories, I came across Nu'ayman ibn Amr, and I was so... That had a deep effect on me. That this was a Sahabi of the Prophet sallallahu... This was the man who made the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam laugh. This was the man that made the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam smile. And what an honor that is in itself. Now, if you look at the life of Nu'ayman ibn Amr, Nu'ayman had been caught drinking a few times, a couple of times. And each time he had been caught drinking, he had been lashed, he had been whipped. The had had been applied to him. And eventually there came a point when the Sahaba ikram began to become restless of him. They began to think, there's no hope for Nu'ayman. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam then said, looked at the Sahaba and their reaction towards Nu'ayman, and he said that if he is to drink one more time, then kill him. If he is to touch alcohol one more time, then kill him. Just as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that, one of the Sahaba ikram, one Sahabi stood up and says to Nu'ayman, Nu'ayman, may the curse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon you. May the curse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon you. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has told you many times, have you no shame? And Nu'ayman began to feel hurt. He was felt hurt by the words of the Sahabi. He felt embarrassed, he felt ashamed. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam looked at the hurt on the face of Nu'ayman and said to that Sahabi, la tasubbuhu, don't curse him, don't harm him, don't hurt him with your words. فَإِنَّهُ يُحِبُّ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. For indeed he loves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger. And this was a character. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had the best of akhlaq, the best of morals. وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. And indeed you have been given the best of morals, the best of character. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam could see this, that Nu'ayman was hurt. And he said this to Nu'ayman, that indeed Nu'ayman loves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger. After that had such a profound effect on Nu'ayman, and he said, I will never ever touch alcohol from this day on. And he never did. Just one or two stories I would just like to tell you from the life of Nu'ayman ibn Amr radiallahu ta'ala. And you'd be thinking that we should be talking about the coming of the month of Ramadan. And I think Shaykh Tanbir has covered that enough. All the verses of the Quran. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. أو you who believe, fasting has been prescribed to you just as it has been prescribed to the ummas and nations before you. لعلكم تتقون, so that you may attain piety. And he has spoke about taqwa in itself. So there's nothing left to discuss there. Let me just leave you with a few stories from the life of this Sahabi who made the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam laugh. There was before the Battle of Badr took place, there were so many ma'arakas. There was expeditions led by the muhajirun, the muhajirun were those who migrated from Mecca, came to Medina, Madinatul Munawwara. And the Ansar were those helpers who lived in Medina already and helped the muhajirun adapt and live into their society. And before the Battle of Badr took place in the month of Ramadan, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Sahaba ikram from amongst the Muhajirun led various expeditions. that took place to see, to intercept caravan, to intercept any news about the Quraysh and their plots, and to attack the Prophet ﷺ and the Muslims. So one of these expeditions was led by none other than Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, and the first Khalifa of Islam, was led by him. And he took a band of about 100 to 150 from amongst the Muhajirun, and they were camped out at this place outside Medina. And the Prophet, then Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq took some of them and went to ride out because he heard of a slave caravan coming through. So he went to intercept them. He went to see and if there was any news about the Quraysh and their plots to attack the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Islam. So he left behind some people and he appointed a leader from amongst them. Whenever the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would leave for a battle, it was his sunnah to appoint a leader, to appoint somebody as an imam to lead the prayers, to guide the people. Just as Sayyidina Abu Bakr, acting upon the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, left behind an imam, somebody who his na'ib, his deputy, to take hold of the affairs while he is gone. And when he had gone, Sayyidina Nu'ayman ibn Amr radiallahu ta'ala was part of those who were left behind. And it became time to eat and it was late. It was time for food and the Sahaba ikram were getting hungry. So Nu'ayman went to the na'ib and says, you know, let's eat. Come and let's eat. And that na'ib, he said, no, we're going to wait for Sayyidina Abu Bakr and the rest of the caravan to come back. And then we're going to partake in our food. Then we're going to eat. We're all going to eat together. And Nu'ayman said, you know, they will eat when they come. Let us eat now. You know, why are you punishing the rest of us? Abu Bakr would want us to eat. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would want us to eat. So that happened, and Nu'ayman became very upset with this. So Nu'ayman went out and he saw a caravan passing by, a slave caravan passing by, and he went to that slave caravan and he says, you know, come here. I have a slave for you. You know, you're gonna, how much money will you give me for him? He's very attakata. He's big. He's strong. You will make great use of this slave. And he's from Makkah al-Mukarram. He's from Makkah. He's come from serving the Quraysh. This is the best of slaves. So you can take him. How much money, how much gold would you give me? So I agreed and haggled with them. He agreed a price with them, how much they would pay him for this slave. And he said to them, let me warn you before you take this slave, that when you take hold of him, take many men with you because he's strong. And he's going to say to you, no, don't take me. I am not a slave. I am from the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I'm a Sahabi of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But don't believe him. He's a slave. He's a madman. He's majnoon. Go and take him. So anyway, he takes the money from them, they go, and he points out to them the knife of Sayyidina Abu Bakr, and he said, that's your slave right there. He's going to tell you that I'm not a slave, but don't believe him, he's a madman. So they went and quickly grabbed hold of him. Or three, four men quickly grabbed hold of him to take him to the caravan and take him away to be sold. And he screams out, and he says, no, I'm not a slave. He said, no. They said to him, don't worry, they laughed and said, your master has already told us that this is what you would say. Your master has already told us that you will tell us that you're not a slave. And while they're taking him away, the rest of the Sahaba that were with Nu'ayman ibn Amr, they began to shout out and say no, that he's not a slave. Just at that time, Sayyidina Abu Bakr with the rest of the caravan came back. And Sayyidina Abu Bakr was informed that this is what's going on, this is the ruckus. And Sayyidina Abu Bakr went and paid that man back. The gold that he had paid Nu'ayman and took Nu'ayman from him. When Sayyidina Abu Bakr went back to Medina, and they would always come to Masjid al-Nabawi, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would always ask them, what news have you got? What has happened? What took place when you left? And Sayyidina Abu Bakr then told them the story of Nu'ayman. In a nice way, we can say the practical joker. What took place, and he's told him the story of Nu'ayman, that this is what took place, and the Sahaba ikram report that we saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam smile and laugh as we had never seen the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam smile and laugh before prior to that day. So you know, when we come to the mosque, when we listen to the Quran being recited, and we listen to the na'at of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and we listen to the speeches which talk about the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, let's sit up attentively, let's smile, let's laugh, let's joke with one another when we leave the mosque, or inside the mosque. When we leave the mosque, greet one another. You know, in a nice and appropriate manner, whenever we see a Muslim brother, let's smile at him. Let's smile at him. Smiling is a sunnah of Rasulullah. Smiling at the face of your brother is a sunnah of Rasulullah. Even a smile. It is sadaqah. It is charity to smile at the face of another Muslim brother. So let's adopt the akhlaq, the morals and character that the Prophet ﷺ and the Sahaba ikram had amongst them, had inside them.